Hi all. In today's digital world, where data is king, managing and presenting this data efficiently is really crucial. Welcome to our tutorial on Introduction to Pagination in ServiceNow Scripted REST API using chooseWindow function, which is supported by GlideRecord. Imagine trying to fetch thousands of records in a single API call. It's not just overwhelming for user, but also put a strain on system resources. This is where pagination comes into play. Pagination is a process that divides content into separate pages instead of loading all data at once. You fetch a subset of data on demand. This makes data retrieval manageable, faster, and more user-friendly. In ServiceNow, the GlideRecord class is widely used and is used to query tables. The chooseWindow function is a powerful feature of GlideRecord. It allows developers to specify a subset of records to be written by setting a start index and end index, making it perfect for implementing pagination. Using chooseWindow has several advantages. It significantly reduces server load by fetching only a portion of records. This results in quicker response time and a smoother user experience, especially when dealing with a large data set. Let's dive into today in a practical use case. We'll create a simple scripted REST API in ServiceNow to fetch configuration item or CIs using pagination. Our API will accept two parameters because we want to define the pagination. So we'll be accepting two parameters, which is page size and page number, to control the amount of data returned. By implementing the chooseWindow function, our API efficiently retrieves data in manageable chunks based on the requested page size and number. Okay, so we can get started with the demo. As you can see on my screen, this is my personal development instance with zoom out to some extent. And what we'll do, we'll be trying today to query this particular table or cmdci.rest. Why? Because this particular table has the most number of records in my instance. So it has 2784. And we'll be creating a simple API which will return only the SSID and the display name of the CIs. So let's get started. For that, what you have to do, we'll go to scripted REST API and we'll create a new API and we will name it as what? What we should name it? We can name it as CMDB. CMDB APIs. Okay, and we can simply save it out and we will not anything out there, and we will go to resources, and in resources we click new, and we will be performing get operation only. So we'll name it out as get CIs. And in relative path, as we discussed, we will be passing two parameters out. So I will give a prefix as CMDB just to differentiate all the APIs out. And then I want to make two attributes, but dynamic. So we can use curly braces and we can give page number and the next one we can give in curly braces page size. Okay, so basically how it works, for instance, if we are providing a number, as if we are providing page number zero, okay, if the page number is zero, that means it's the first page, and if we are passing size as 20, so it will pass the first 20 records. If we pass page number as one, okay, or we can consider it as two, okay, one, two. So if we consider two, and if you pass the data set size as 20, so it will send out 20 to 40 number of record, okay, not the initial ones. So what, how to write the logic for the same? So first and foremost thing, we have to pull the path parameter. So how we can pull it out? I will give variable page size equal to quest dot path params dot, like exactly I have given its base size, right? So I will just take this one. And I'm pulling it from this particular place, right? The dynamically parsed attributes. I'm just taking it from there. Okay. And in the similar way, we can have it for page number also. Number it's page number. Now we have both the attributes. Perfect. So I can expand it out because I don't need any other reference. Now what we want to do, we want to set some default values to the page initial, because there's a possibility that we are not passing any values, or when the API is called from the third party system, they forget to pass it out or something like that. So we will set some default value because we don't want to send corrupt data, junk data to them, right? So here we will set default nation values, and for that, how we can do that? Page size equal to page size. Is it present? If it's yes, then we will do parse it. And it will be page size. We are just converting it to integer. Okay. And I will set the default value as 10. If nothing is passed, it will be 10. Perfect. In the similar way, we can have the page number also. So I'll just copy paste it out. This time it will be page number. And it will be page number, pass in page number. And we want to set default value as 1 over here. Why? Because you want, if nothing is passed, you don't want to pass the data from the 10th page, right? You want it from the first page itself. So that's the reason. Then we'll create an offset. So calculate offset. Offset will be like, what is the start? We can consider it, right? So we can do variable offset equal to, I will just use basic maths, page number minus 1 into page size. So for an instance, if page number is passed as 2, right? And if page size is 10, so how exactly it will count? It will count 2 minus 1 is 1, okay, 1, and what will the page size, okay, so it's 10, so it will start counting from 10 number. Why so? Because the counting, it follows the index logic of the string, because it considers the first iteration as 0, and then start counting 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. That's why we need this logic. Now, after that, we need variable CLList. I will make it a blank array. Then we will do a glide record. Well, CI, I will not use it in short. CI equal to new glide record. And it will be on CMWCI. CI. Now, what needs to happen? So we have to set, we will not add any query, but if you want, you can add queries also. But I will directly jump to the window. So you can do grci dot choose window And here we will pass the, it's like it has two attributes if you consider. So the first attribute is the number, okay, and the second attribute is also number. And force count is like if it's gr, it's a, if force count is true, gr count method will return all possible records. Okay, so the first number is like from where to where it should start and end. You can consider it in a simple language, right? So we will give it over here offset, and what should be the end? So it should be simply offset, sorry, offset comma offset plus page size. So for an instance, I just want to define it over here. So for an instance, if page size is equal to 10 and we want for page number 3, right? So how, which record will get processed, which record will get? So the offset formula is like, where exactly it went? Over here, page number, which is 3 minus 1, so 2 multiply by 10, it's 20. So it will be like from 20 to, what is this particular, what is the end? Is that offset plus page size? So what is the page size? 10, right? And 20, so it's 30. So it will return 20 to 30 records, 20 to 30 row number records. Perfect. So that's how it works. So I'll just comment it out just to keep you in loop. And then what we want to do while, no, we want to query first, right? So grcl dot query. And then while grcl dot next, next should have this, it's a function. Next, what we need to do, we have to just push it out. So how we can do, we have to push it out in the CI list. So CI list dot push, and we want to push a JSON object, right? So how we can define it out? Push, I will give the curly brace, which stands for a JSON object, right? And over here I can give says ID equal to grci dot get unique value, and then comma the next attribute. You can add as many attribute as you want, okay, when you want to consume the API, but just for demo purpose, and we are not serving this particular as a use case. We just want to explore on the choose window and how exactly it will work on the scripted REST API. So I will just add two attributes. Second one, I will keep it as name equal to grci dot get display value. Okay, no comma at that. I'll just format the code out once. Perfect. And then we can simply return CI list. Perfect, we are done with the code. Now let's test it out. So I will just save this out. If you want to test it out on the console on the scripted REST API only, so you can simply do this REST API Explorer. Okay, so I will just click on this. CMDB API. We have this particular API, and as you can see, it asks for two path parameters, which is page number and page size. Perfect. So let's consider I want it from the first page, and I want only two records. So now you will understand the power of this choose window function and pagination. So first page, two records. If I send it out, right, it gives 200. We got two records. Perfect. It sounds like perfect, right? Now, if I want five records, it made it completely dynamic, this API. If I send this, then I got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That's also good. Now, if I want, four records, but from not from the first page, but from the third page. Okay, so it will return that records also, the specific window records. So if I send it out, so it has written 1, 2, 3, 4, and this record are not from the start. So if you do order by, so in the order, you can put order on anything, name or any unique context, right? And it will do the ordering, and basically it will put the record based on the window which you have provided. So this is how it's pretty important. Okay, this is where it adds value, right? Because pagination is really important, because if some third party application is consuming this API, right, and whenever they're calling this API, if I'm throwing them around lakhs or 2 lakhs of records, you know, CMDBC level, at least have this much of records, right, then it will be screwed up, the next system will be screwed up, right? So pagination adds a lot of value over there. Okay, it's really, really important. So this is all for today's tutorial. In today's tutorial, we have seen how we can use the choose window function of the GlideRecord in scripted REST API and what are the advantages of it with one use case. So thank you for watching, and don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more tutorials. Dive into the world of efficient data handling with us. Okay. Till then, stay safe, stay happy, have a nice day. Thank you.